In the past, only a few gifted people composed music. But people nowadays say we no longer need such gifts, thanks to computer and software. So, is composing music easy for you? No way. Music composition is still a challenging task, but thanks to AI, music creation in the near future is possible for everyone, and we aspire to lead the journey. How we could produce music that is on a similar level done by human composers? As many of you here would most likely be already interested in AI, you may have heard of either big models or foundation models that self-paced learning is done with enormous amount of data, like GPT-3 or DALL-E. As you can see here, these are the artworks done by DALL-E, a model made by a research institute called OpenAI, which produces a painting when an instruction is given. You will be surprised to hear this, but these two are the works done by DALL-E 1 and 2 when a given the phrase "a fox sitting on top of a hill at sunrise" in Claude Monet's style. This is another work done with DALL-E 2, showing its capability to interact with a human. What you see here on the left is the original image, and what you see on the right is an image produced by DALL-E 2. Being asked to paint flamingos in drawing 3, it is amazing how even the reflection of the flamingos on the water was so distinctly manifested. What's more, there are even poetry books being published with poems written using GPT-3. In reality, though, many of us here have probably not been exposed to AI music yet. This is because musical data are very different in nature to other types of data, such as an image or a language. There are endless amount of image and language data out on the internet. However, musical data are never enough. In other words, it is difficult to build a self-paced big model in the field of music composition due to lack of data. We overcame this obstacle using two strategies, divide and conquer, and successful objective breakdown of music. First, the divide and conquer strategy allows us to create a pipeline of music generation through multiple models with a specific task, rather than having a single model to all the work. Furthermore, the success of objective breakdown of music lies in creating a quality data set that is well tagged, easy to understand for a computer, and is objective. Our research and development in AI music generation is totally based on these two strategies. It allows us to build the best performing existing AI model. Here is a point I want to make to everyone. The popular big model is not the only solution when making industrial applications of AI. We must bring our wisdoms for experience in our own field, make our best attempt in dissolving those wisdoms into data, understand the limits of artificial intelligence, break down the questions at hand into what an AI could understand, then tackle the problem. Then we may be able to find clues to unanswered questions. You may be thinking writing notes on you matters. In fact, the process of music generation requires various complicated tasks such as using the appropriate virtual instruments, mixing and mastering, etc. Our divide and conquer strategy and the objective breakdown of music is applied to all these processes in order to open a new way to tackle the complicated steps in music generation. What is notable is that we did not simply use the objective metric often used in AI music composition, but added controllability and diversity metric to it. We expect our model to maximize diversity in controlled circumstances. Unlike the academia, we can never run away from copyright problems in real life. Thus, maximizing diversity of produced music is a crucial task. It is also notable that we got a win rate of 42. It means that 42% of people preferred AI music samples over the one created by a human composer. We have also done a blind test which showed people really can't distinguish between music created by an AI and by a human composer when it used all of our data set. Now, let me walk you through what combinatorial music generation looks like. Because we understand the limits of artificial intelligence, we only asked our AI to do what AI can do. As you will hear soon, samples produced during stage one are relatively simple. However, when combined during stage two, it suddenly turned into a beautiful piece of music. What you will hear in stage two is made by only combining five samples generated from stage one. This is the first sample. The second. Third sample. Fourth. And last but not the least, the fifth sample. Now, let's listen to the piece made by combining only the five samples. When I heard that the first time, to me, it was mind-blowing. Now, let me share with you yet another impressive example of the work. Here goes the first. The second. Third. Fourth sample. And finally, the fifth. Again, let's now listen to what is done in stage two. It'll be fun trying to find where these samples were used in full-length music while you are listening to the music. how did that make you feel? I hope it amazed you as much as it amazed me. Thanks to AI and our strategies, we can infinitely produce unique samples with various combinations of metadata. But what's the use of all these technologies if the next generation can't benefit from it? The answer is in metaverse. Let me walk you through how AI music takes part in metaverse, where every one of us could become a creator. We all know Facebook, one of the tech giants, changed its name to Meta. Meta is so sure metaverse will be the next big thing, just like how Facebook impacts connecting the whole world through social media. Jensen Huang, the CEO of NVIDIA, said in the next 20 years, what you see only in the science fiction movies will soon happen because metaverse is coming. As young generation tend to spend more time in the metaverse, many brands are starting various marketing campaigns in metaverse. Plus, a metaverse commerce has already taken place. Global fashion brand Gucci, Dior, and Nike have already opened stores to increase brand awareness toward younger generations. Plus, users could really buy stuff at metaverse stores. Music industry actually utilized the metaverse as well. For example, Blackpink held a real-time virtual signing event in Geppetto, and 46 million fans all around the globe joined. With technology to create music with AI, we may be able to host events where artists and fans can create music together. Just imagine yourself making your music with your favorite artist. Isn't that cool? Real concerts of global superstars in the metaverse are taking place now. For example, Travis Scott put on a virtual concert in Fortnite by Epic Games. $20 million had been earned, and the revenue was 10 times bigger compared to the traditional concert. Finally, could you imagine a world without music, movies, important events like this forum, celebrations? No music to listen to while you are working or driving. Not even when we simply want a background music when we are feeling sad. Nothing. Now, imagine a world where you and I are able to create our own music. What would it be like? I'm sure many of us here wish to create our own music, but at the same time feel like we do not have what it takes to make one. With AI technology, people with no musical gift will find it effortless to create one. Professional composers will also reduce repetitive tasks and get inspirations from AI technology.